ultra mega with those respective caps of 25 lakhs, 35 lakhs and 50 lakhs. SGST reimbursement, 30% of what is sold within the state for large and 50% for mega and ultra mega. Stamp duty exemption of 50%. ETP, effluent treatment plant, if somebody puts an in situ ETP, then 30% up to 50 lakhs. Extra employment subsidy beyond a particular threshold, if there is an employment for every male employee, 500 rupees per month, and for every female employee, 700 per month would be given by the state. Land registration fee rebates, power assistance. This is a major component. We have a cost of around 4.99 per unit. On that, you would get a rebate of 1 rupees. Over and above that, 100% rebate on electric duty for 7 years. Land rate rebates. These are the rebates given within the circle areas. Depending on whether it is a large, mega or ultra mega investment, you would be getting a rebate of 15, 25 and 30%. This is a central government scheme which is unique to the three Himalayan states and the Northeast. Central capital investment, 30% of the investment in plant and machinery with an upper limit of 5 crores. And a central comprehensive insurance incentive. Any premium that is given for the insurance of the plants and machinery would be reimbursed by the central government for a period of 5 years. Mm-hmm. Coming to the startup policy, we've got a monthly allowance for those who are into startups for 1 year at rupees 10,000 per month. For those who belong to the special category, SC, ST, women, physically challenged, we've got 15,000 per month. A marketing assistance of 5 lakhs for publicity, 7.5 lakhs for those who come under the special category. Up to 100% reimbursement of actual cost of startups for patent fees. A stamp duty exemption. SGST reimbursement, a 25% discount on the incubation space for the startups, a need-based assistance of 5 lakhs towards raw material components, etc. And for incubators, we give 1 crore for setting up, that is almost 50% of their capital cost, running expense of 2 lakhs per year, and a matching grant. In the sense, incubators are recognized by central government also. So, say suppose the state government recognizes the incubator, the matching grant is given by the state government. We have a mega textile park policy with 7% interest subsidy for 7 years with a cap of 50 lakhs, stamp duty exemption of 100%, power assistance, same as the mega policy, land rate rebate, 50% flat. Now coming to the policies which are in the pipeline, we have a Uttarakhand vehicle manufacturing policy in which we have proposed an interest subsidy of 7% per annum, interest then industrial subsidy rate, that is for R&D, 5% per annum with a cap of 1 crore, electricity duty exemption, stamp duty exemption, EPF reimbursement, SGST reimbursement, concession in land costs, ETP, some provisos for skill development and tax exemptions. We have also come up with an anchor unit policy. These are for big investments. These are basically categorized into two areas. One is the focus areas and the second is the service areas. The threshold for availing the incentives for preferential sectors, which are the focus sectors, is pitched slightly lower. The brackets are from 200 to 300, 300 to 500 and above 500 for the focus sectors, and for other services it is 250 to 350, 350 to 550 and above 550. So when we come broadly, when we see the broad concessions that we are giving, we'll get a land rate subsidy from varying from 40% to 50% in a staggered manner. For the ones with the 200 crore investment, it will be 45% and then 50% for above 550. Interest subsidy of 10% for next 5 years for maximum of 75 lakhs. 100% exemption on payment of electricity duty shall be given for the next 10 years from the commencement time. Capital subsidy of 50% for establishment of ETP subject to a maximum of 1 crore. 100% rebate on stamp duty on registration of purchase lease deed on the land. So these are the salient features of our anchor policy. These are the places where our seed pool areas are there.
Understood.
Yes, yes, please. Highly excuse.
They are not being.
We have given a copy of all these policies in the brochure that you have. So you can, these are the proposed policies at the first draft. If you have any suggestions, you can get back to us. And I cordially invite you all for the summit that we are holding on the 7th and 8th of October. Thank you.